MySQL DataFlows is a powerful tool that allows users to transform data within Domo by leveraging the power of SQL. To create a MySQL DataFlow, click Data and then select SQL from the Magic Transform ribbon. This will open up our authoring environment. The first thing we need to do is give our DataFlow a name and description. In this example, we're going to be joining forecast data with sales data. Now that the DataFlow has a name, we can combine the data by bringing in the two input datasets that we want to work with. Let's take a closer look at these datasets by clicking on the dataset here and selecting the Preview tab. We can see that we have our forecast broken out by day, and we have our sales by day as well. We're going to join these two sources on the date column, but as we can see right here, we have multiple different sales recorded per date in this dataset. This can cause problems when joining datasets together on these fields by causing duplications to appear. So we want to make sure to aggregate the sales data down so there is only one unique row per day. We need to group and summarize the sales data, so let's add our first transform and give it a name. We'll call it Group Sales. In the main section of the transform, we will enter in the SQL query that will aggregate the data down to day. We will select date and the sum of sales as the columns we want to pull from our original dataset, then group by date. If we run a preview, we can see that there is only one row per date and the sales column is now aggregated. Click Apply to save the changes and we can move on to the next step now that we have our summarized sales data. At this point, we're ready to join our forecast and sales data together. We will create another transform and name it Join Forecast Sales. First, we will select the date and forecast data from our forecast dataset and only the aggregated sales column from the sales dataset, since we don't need two of the sale date columns. Let's run a preview on this join transform and make sure that all the data matches up. We can see here that the data looks good and there are no duplicate values being returned. Now that our join is created, we want to make sure our join runs as quickly as possible, so we will add indexes for the join columns using easy indexing on each table we are pulling data from. This allows the system to process through these key columns quickly and compile a list of values to join on. Let's choose date on the forecast input and date on the aggregated sales transform. The last thing we want to do is create our output dataset. The name that we give it here will be the name we search for when creating cards and if you are trying to find it in the data center. After naming it, we will enter in select star from join forecast sales. This will return all the data from our last transform as our final output dataset. Now that we have finished creating the data flow, we need to choose when it updates. Data flows have a manual, scheduled, and trigger-based system to choose from. By choosing a trigger-based system, you can select as few or as many dataset inputs needed to trigger the data flow when they update. It's important to note that when the data flow starts, it pulls a snapshot of all the data from each input. So if one of your inputs updates while the data flow is running, it will not pull in that data. This means you want to trigger them strategically and choose an option that updates last out of all of the inputs. Once you have selected the settings you need, you can save and run the data flow. You will then be able to watch it process from the History tab. Once it is run, you are ready to start creating cards to answer all of your business questions.